Alrighty, welcome back. This is where we're at. I've got some filler on the chassis. I haven't got it all filled out, but I put quite a bit on. You know, I don't want to get overwhelmed by having it covered too much, I guess, but I have got it covered. I've got some smaller work to do in there and stuff like that to do that, and that's just going to take a little bit of time. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how I bust it off. But first, my daughter came home last night, and she's sniffling, and she's probably not feeling the greatest. So what I'm going to do, just to show you what I do when any chance like that comes along, we've got filters in our neck. They're called lymph nodes. And I'm just going to tap that lymph node right in that hole there. I'm going to tap that bad boy, make sure it's working. Because if any toxins are in your body, that's where it gets cleared out. And I just want to do a little facial cleanse before we do it. And all I'm doing is making sure my lymph nodes are running to go down through my lymph nodes to take out any toxins. And that way there, I will not get sick, or I'll have a better chance of not getting sick. And basically just rub your face and rub down behind your ears. Do that. I'm just going to rub my face here for a second. Get my lymph nodes going. Let's just make sure that my lymph node system is working. And it's just like your oil system in your car. If you do not have an oil filter on it, all that dirty stuff keeps running through. It does not get caught, does not filter out. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that I have a little bit of protection from anything that is available out there. And if you feel like you would like to have a little bit of protection, get your lymph nodes running. There's a hole right there in the side of your neck, a little hole in the other side of your neck there. Give it a tap, then massage your face, try to run it down through. And I guarantee you, there will be someone message and say, wow, I felt my face drain. Guarantee it, if you try it. Let's carry on with this right here. And it just takes a minute, you know, it just takes a second. It will not hurt you. You might feel a little foolish at first, but I do it all the time because I feel like it's a simple process. And it's something that will not hurt you. And if it does not hurt you and it can help you, why would you not? Why would you not? I can't understand why it's not mandatory, to be honest with you, or why it has not been told to the public, you know, that you have a lymph node system that is your filter system. Why would we not be told that? I'm not sure, but I just told you so you can thank me. Hit the holes in the side of your neck, massage your face, and those who that are filled up will feel it drain, I guarantee you. Do you do it, Jolene? Jolene does it too. I haven't been sick for a long time, at least. I haven't been sick for 5 years. I have not been sick for 5 years. And how I found this out, I was laying in bed, and I seen it on the internet. A doctor was talking about it, lymph node drainage. I tried it. I felt it drain. It wasn't two and three days before I started feeling good. And I have never stopped because it's a simple thing to do. And I do it. I just took the hot air gun, just put it on there to soften the glue up. When you peel them off sometimes, the glue sticks on your DA. This is an electric DA. It's a porta cable. I like the electric DA because we do not have to have the air compressor running full time. That's why I like it. We got Zach in the house. He's down sanding moldings for Elvis. They're in there. He's sanding them all down. For a second here, I see him maybe doing a little finger sanding, maybe. I like to see you swipe those, Zachy. Just swipe them like this, please, instead of doing like this. You start doing that, and then you start seeing finger marks. And just swipe them like this, like that. Please and thank you. Instead of going like this. Just had to catch them there. If your papers wore out, grab a new piece. Does he have a new piece of paper? You have new paper right here, Zach? There you go, sir. What we did is we guy coat all that stuff so he knows exactly how much to sand off and how much not to sand off. This is an 80 grit. An 80 grit on the DA. Okay. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a little mask myself. Why not? I'll grab a mask myself. Put that on. On this car, there's probably a lot of new people watching on this car, I think. I'm not sure, but we're seeing to be gaining on Facebook and YouTube. There's a lot of new people. This is the chassis for the Bugatti. All the stuff like the radiator, the rack and pinion, and all that stuff. You know, everybody's, you know, saying move this, move that. I cannot move anything. I have an eighth of an inch on the top of the radiator on the top of this side, an eighth of an inch on top of this side. The rack is where it needs to go. It's the only place it can go. The radiator is where it needs to go. Everything is so compact because it's such a small car. If you can tell, like, not many cars are that thick, you know, what I mean by that thick or that high, you know, through the whole length of the body. And that means that I am trying to pack all this stuff into a little tiny area. And that's what makes it a sports car, when you're trying to pack all this stuff that you need in the smallest car possible. I said many times that the car is not made for a big person. It's made for a small person like Jolene. That's basically what it's for. It's sort of, I would say, a race car of its day. And like I said, you would never put a 300-pound man on a horse and expect him to win a race when you could put a small person on like Jolene. You know, that's what this car is about. And that's why I'm such an issue with everything, with the radiator, with the rack. And also I'm building it as I go, but I still have to fit everything in such a tight area. Nothing can be moved. And when you say something can be moved, it can't. I shouldn't say can't. It can't. I'm trying to fit it in the car the best I can. Also, they were saying someone scratched the frame up. If you've ever sandblasted anything, you're not going to get much rougher than sandblasting. The chassis feels like a cat's tongue. And if you've never felt a cat's tongue before, it's quite rough. And like the dog wiped his ass with sandpaper. Rough. It's rough. So that's why the filler is sticking good. That's why I'm not grinding it or anything. That's very coarse. And that's the way it should be. Tap your lymph nodes. Make sure your lymph node system is working. That is your filter system for any toxins that go through your body. And it makes sense at this point in life to make sure your filter system is working with a tap on the lymph nodes. Why would you not? Alrighty, what I'm going to do now is just going to rub this off, and I'm going to show you how I'm going to rub it off. And I'm going to try to do it as quick as possible because, you know, it's a chassis, and all we're trying to do is smooth it off and make it nice when we prime it. And all I'm trying to do is take out the picks and that sort of stuff. So here we go. And I put more on than I need it, because the reason being is that I can't sand it off and make it look nice if I don't have more than I need. And I'm allowed to tip this a little bit, tip my grinder or my DA a little bit, because I'm not looking for straightness, I'm looking for to fill the pits. You can see the chassis coming through there, and I can see it. It looks kind of, you can see how it's filling the pinholes or picks or whatever in it, the pitty stuff, and that's all I'm trying to do is get it down like that to fill it all in. There's a better version. You can see it there. That's what's going on. Now that's how thick I'm going to be. It's smooth there, so I'm going to leave it, but that's what I'm going for. This is an 80 grit on a DA. is metal showing on all the corners, and it's just because that's the high spot. Want to get enough filler on it to fill the pinholes. Should be no real pinholes in this, but I wanted to fill the whole thing to make it smooth and right. You can see on this chassis that I left some of the weld mark, and I want that there for strength. I do not want to take that all off because I would have no strength left. And I leave that little bit of weld on there because that's, to me, I'm defeating the purpose if I take it all off. Grab another one. It's going to burn the 80 grit up quite quickly. Yes, it is, but that's the name of the game, I guess. You have to have a little bit of material, I guess, to do what you need to get done. You can see I've got metal showing there, it's just very thin. And what will happen is that body filler will accept the primer and do a nicer, smoother job than sandblasted metal. When I first started doing body work, I had, I didn't have the shop and everything that I needed. So what I would do is I'd run house to house and do their body work right at their house. I'd go right to their home, right to their garage and do body work. And I had electric DA, and that means I could do all my body work with my DA because I didn't need an air compressor. I didn't need anything other than the tools I had, grinder, air compressor, or not an air compressor, electric DA, electric grinder, and I really enjoyed it. It was fun to go around people's places. I'd paint cars, I'd do bodywork to cars, I'd weld pieces on cars, did a lot of stuff running house to house. Digging at it right now. I'm not holding it flat. I'm trying to get in here. So I'm digging at it a little bit. But I want it smooth, not straight. There's a difference. You see where I'm at. Getting the picks there. going to do. I'm going to put a 40 on it just because I'm not going fast enough. Look at that, would you? I'm not going fast enough, I don't think. Not for my likings. Think I can get it done a little faster. This is a 40 grit. I'm gonna throw that on, maybe take it off a little bit faster, then hit it with an 80 after. Just wanna go a little bit faster, that's all. See the metal. I want to get a different pad. I want to get a different pad. Got my clickers on. Why is that? I got used paper in there. I guess I'm recycling. Huh, baby? Recycling. And it's something else too, because we're not even going to see this. It's going to be buried underneath the underneath the body of the car. But when it's all done, it's going to look some nice. See the chassis. That's a 40 grit. I'll have to go over that with an 80 grit. That is the top part. I think I'll do the top part on that side. Show the easy stuff first, I guess. Maybe that's what's going on. I don't have to do the side. I may as well do the side. I might as well do the whole thing. Do this side. I don't know if you know it or not, but I am a fight fan. I am a fight fan. I like UFC. I like boxing. I like all that stuff. But some of the stuff that's that's on TV and being promoted as fights, it's a sad day in the sport. It's a sad day. When wow. I don't think I have to say anything, but it's very sad what's going on. To me, it's fraud. I don't want to get down there too much. I want to dig it off the other way if I can. I always put on more than I need. That way there I can sand it off. And have what I want. If I don't put on more than I need, then you know what happens. I keep going back over to the old can and start mixing more. That's what happens. Don't want that. Just want to continue on and try to do it one time if I can. And in that fight game, one of them is no better than the other one, if you know what I'm trying to say. There's no one better than the other one on that fight, that was. They're both doing it for the almighty dollar. And to me, your integrity's gone. Haven't got any. You might have some money, but you got no integrity. And there's no amount of money gonna buy my integrity. That's all I got. My integrity. With primer on that, that's gonna be so smooth and so nice. Wow, lovey-dovey. Excuse me. Tap them lymph nodes, get that filter system going. Keep yourself healthy. Trying to go down and see some metal, that's all. Going to the ocean floor. Gonna be a lot of sanding to do this, but when it's all done and all smoothed off, it's really gonna look like something. We're gonna try to finish this up this month, are we not? What is it, the middle of the month? A little better? 21st? Oh yeah, it's almost Christmas! Merry Christmas! I'm wondering if that's true or not. It's hard to believe anything anymore, isn't it? What? Crazy! I got a funny story. Me and Jolene were on the internet. We were looking at cars, like we always do, looking at cars and that sort of stuff. We come across this car that Jolene liked, and when Jolene likes something, well, I'm on board because, you know, that's who I am. Hey, man, I want to keep my woman happy, and cars make me happy, so it's a win-win, really, when Jolene likes a car. So anyways, we called about this car, and I asked him a few questions about it and stuff like that. And Joey said, well, tell him who you are. So anyways, I said, have you ever watched a show called Bad Chad Customs? And he said, yes, I did. And he said, I don't like that guy at all. And I said, well, you're talking to him. He goes, he said, well, you swear too much. And I said, well, when I meet you, he said, I'll try not to swear. But I do like your car. But it was quite funny that I don't like that guy at all, he said. He swears too much. Didn't he, baby? But it was a funny story. I think in the end, I probably could coerce him to maybe like me. I wouldn't swear around him, that sort of stuff. But he has to understand on the show when we were in the moment, that's when we were filmed and caught doing the things that I was doing. And I guess I thought it was right for the moment because that's the moment I was in. When we filmed here, it was 12 hours a day, and they filmed everything I said to everything I did. And one thing we did get a compliment on, come from the big boys above, and that's Discovery, that we were the least racial grudge they've ever been in their life. That's one thing I can say. We're the least racial grudge they've ever been in their life. And that was a great compliment, I thought, because that I'm not. Yeah, I don't like that guy. That metal. Yeah, I don't like that guy. That was our joke for the night. Me and Jolene laughed all night. And the reason I laughed, because his opinion is none of my business, if you know what I'm saying. It's not on my brain what he's thinking, so it's really none of my business how he feels. But it was kind of neat to hear, actually. It was because you know that there is people that don't like. And he said it, and he was talking to me, and I got to hear it. And it did not bother me that much. And I guess the reason being is, like I said, his opinion is none of my business, and I'm not trying to please anybody but myself and Jolene. Basically, that's it. That's the way I think everybody should be. Please yourself. That's how you become happy. And not worrying about what somebody else thinks about you. Because generally, they don't really know you. The corners are rounded off. We'll probably round the corners off. The corners are quite sharp on the filler, but I wanted it that way because I wanted to cover all the metal. And I'm just going to keep on sliding along here. Well, then we'll get to see what a rail looks like. See metal? So we're close. Not very thick. It's not very fast. You see the old DA? I could work this thing all day, or work me all day, not stop, no power loss. Holding it flat along the sides here, trying to get them pickers out. And I will. Metal showing. We're good. We're good, man. We're good. I don't like that guy. Yeah, it was too funny. Too funny. Thank you. getting dolled up. I'm gonna use a new one. Reason I can tear that off like that, because it's warm, the glue's warm because I'm using it, but when it's cold and you go to rip it off, it'll stick on there on you, and that's why I get the heat gun out, but where it's warm like that, it's good. Yeah, it's good. Not as good as you, Jolene, but good. How you making out, Zach? How you making out? Are you waxing on, waxing off?
Wax on, wax off, brother.
Okay.
Might need a new piece of paper.
Yep, new paper right there. Yeah, good. Just take your sandpaper and just we'll do a little bit of this in there.
Yeah,
just a little bit of that. That'd be fine. Okay. Cool. Looks good. Here, when you do that sort of stuff, don't lay it on top of each other. Lay it somewhere else. What, you got your woman's ring on? Is that your ring?
She left it in my truck and I found it.
Did she? Well, good for you. You'll be the king of the world.
I know.
Found your ring.
I know. Right?
You can see how the texture of the primer and Zach sanding it off. With the guide coat, you would never know, generally. You use your third piece of sandpaper, did you, Zach?
I did.
Good man. Good man.
Thanks,
no worries. Here we go, just like that. Back up to getting what I'm doing, doing what I'm doing. Doing what I'm doing. Yeah, sad day for the sports world. You get doing stuff like that, then you never know the truth, and you never know if anybody's, you know, where are we going to a society where no one knows the truth? Terrible. Gonna be some dirty sand in there underneath those mounts, but it had picks there, and it has to me, it has to be done. If we're gonna do the frame, we're gonna do it right, I guess. Get it smoothed off. That metal showing. Metal showing. So when you look underneath Jolene's car and you see the frame and it's nice and shiny and smooth, you'll know why. Because we worked at it. Keep looking underneath your car, we'll kick him in the ass, won't we? matter if it's straight. It just matters that it's just filling just enough on to fill the pit. That's all that matters. I got enough on. There it is, just going to the metal. That's all I want to do. You can see how the metal's coming through, how it's spotty. That just means that the body fill is covering the picks. It's doing the job that we want it to do. What it's doing. The sandpaper that we got there. We'll round the tops off after we get that done. There's going to be a lot of sanding here, and I'm going to get some help. Was you allowed to bet on that fight? They'll have to call that WWE wrestler boxing. I never thought of that. Yep, it's their new sport, WWE boxing. Don't want to dig at it too much. Don't want to groove it. I don't want to groove it. But I want to get the, you know. See metal showing there. See the metal showing? Where we at? Let's do what we can do. Give you an hour of good sanding is what we're gonna give you. An hour of good sanding. Now it's an 80 grit after this, but get knocked off of this 40 grit. Get that the best, that's all. Bum, 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 bum. Going for it, I am. Get one side done. Leave the rest of Jolene and Zach. I think someone suggested maybe feather fill the whole thing. Just be too much product, and you would, I don't know if you get it on there like that thick, I'm not sure. You'd still have to sand it. Yes, you would. We'll use feather fill on after we get it on at 80 grit, we will. But we will. This way. Ouch. That didn't hurt me. Bum, 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 bum. not worried about anything cracking or coming off. It's too thin for that. And if it cracks, it's because the frame is cracked. We've got, I think, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we've got 20 body mounts on this car. For this frame to twist and go on, you'd have to twist the car. We've got 20 body mounts. Most don't have 20. Most cars don't have 20 mounts. And the only reason I put 20 in it is because I want it sturdy as possible. And obviously, I don't think Jolene's going road racing. Ouch! Road racing with this thing, I don't think. Are you, Jolene? Not going road racing. Nope. Little die grinder tool will be nice in there. Little die grinder. Use whatever tool I can to make it. Yeah, looks good. In the end, I'll just take it, rub off the corner, just make it nice and round so it looks good. So it looks good. Oh, I forgot. Be careful on the edges, Zach. Try not to hit metal.
Okay.
Cool. And the reason being for that, just that, you know, you shouldn't paint bare metal. Not should have something on it. Just on the edges, it's hard. It's easy to go through. Yeah, you start hitting metal. Back off. Back off. There. See where I got metal there? Ouch. I don't like that guy. Let's go here a little bit. Gonna knock that off with the broom. Hurting my nose, that thing. So that'll have to be hit with an 80 grit. But you can see, or I can see, how nice, when you throw a little primer on, how much nicer that chassis is going to be if I didn't throw any primer on it. And you would see pits in it. You would see the weld marks in it and that sort of stuff. And where we have it like this and we're trying to do a good job on it, we'll throw a little filler on it. We'll do the best job we can. We'll even throw a little bit of filler on where, if there's any scratch marks in this. And this here, we can throw a little filler on so you can't see the weld marks. We've got it welded on the inside, so it does not matter. Up in here, it's all welded again. That's fine. We'll grind it off a little bit. We'll grind this off and make it look a little right. Take a little skiff of body fill. Will not hurt a dang thing. Now, the inside is going to be a rough one because you see where we're going to go underneath all those mounts. But we'll get them because we got many fingers. Mine, Jolene, and Zach's. And that's what we'll do. We'll try to get this in primer. And then it has to be sanded again, right to 400, and then it can be painted. But until then, there's lots of work to go on. But let's give away a hat or a shirt. Oh, she forgot the computer. I love her just as much anyways, boys. I do. I love her just as much anyways. It might have been a hard watch on this one, but you know what? It's what I had to do. Zach's in sanding moldings because that's what I'd like for him to do. Basically, I wanted to do this to show how I'm doing it. The lowrider guys would be proud of me because they see me filling it out just like they do it. No doubt in my mind. We got this stuff we got to do. If there's anything that looks bad, I can rub a little filler on that. Yes, I can. Smoothen that all off. Make that look like you've never been fixed or never been made. You know, I can. And I might. But anyways, that's how it's done. And that's what I'm going to do on the other side. And the whole thing has to be done. Then we have to flip it upside down and get that side done. Wow, we got lots of work to do. Alrighty, tap them lymph nodes, get your lymph nodes moving, massage your face, make sure it's running. And if your face drains, if you feel your face drain, your lymph nodes are working, you got them working and you can feel it when it drains. And if you do, make sure you write down a little comment and say, yeah, it worked. See you later, everybody.